So, hello everyone. Welcome to today's webinar, all about the Warwick's repertory, given by Oscar E. Warwick. You are used to Dr. Oscar E. Warwick. Generally, we used to confuse between William Warwick, who was the author of Warwick's Materia Medica, and Oscar E. Warwick, who introduced Warwick's repertory in William Warwick's Materia Medica. It was later on attached with the William Warwick's Materia Medica. So, let us start with it. So, what was Dr. Oscar E. Warwick's repertory was all about? It's one of the most useful clinical repertory what we have in homeopathic literature, along with Clark and along with Fartuck. This repertory I use a lot. So, Oscar E. Warwick is the most widely used bedside clinical repertory which has been attached to homeopathic Materia Medica by William Warwick. It is based on the Materia Medica by William Warwick. The repertory contains clinical symptoms and the corresponding group of medicine. They facilitate the selection of the basis of pathological similarity, causation, modality, and concomitant. The medicine which are not overtly indicated for a particular diagnosis or condition tentatively ruled out from a consideration in prescription in a normal practice. That's probably the reason why Dr. Oscar E. Warwick invented the Warwick's repertory. Interesting. The concept or totality of Dr. Warwick's. Cause, type, clinical, pathology, investigation, location, sensation, concomitant, modalities, aggravation and amelioration. Arrangement of rubrics. Rubrics and subrubrics are arranged alphabetically. Subrubrics are arranged cause, type, location, character of pain, modalities. So, for a type, for a subrubric, for example, headache, what will be the cause of the headache? What will be the type of the headache? What is the location? Frontal, parietal, temporal, occipital. Character of this pain. What is the type of character of the pain? And the modality. When he aggravated and it ameliorated. Some of the special features of Dr. Warwick's report. Their largest section is the female sexual character spread over 24 pages. The smaller section is the tongue spread over only one page. The largest number of rubrics are in skin section. It has 102 main rubrics. And least number of rubrics are in the gum section. It has only one main rubric. So some of the interesting rubrics I want to discuss with you. This is a very special rubric. I use it so many times. Deafness, hardness of hearing, remedies in general, sclerotic condition. There is something sclerotic element, something hardness in the conducting tendinitis system of the ear. We can think of two remedies. That is ferumping and thiocyanine. I use thiocyanine a lot in these type of cases where the deafness due to sclerotic eruption. Interesting. So our next rubric will be Veruca. That means warts. Bleed. What's that bleed? So this is the rubric. It's a cinnaberis. You never find this type of rubric in any other repertory. It's a cinnaberis. It's a gem. Warwick repertory is a gem. We all should use it. We have to use it in our practice if you want to deal with the clinical cases. This is rubric, I used a lot, So that's the rubric, you know. This is a very important rubric, you know. And nowadays, their urine, diabetes, sugar, melancholy, emaciation, thrush with restlessness. You find this type of patient nowadays. It's so felonious. How will you get this type of rubrics in any report? I can't know. So our next rubric will be gums burning. That is self a PQRS. How many of you have seen patient with gums burning? I don't think any of you have seen this type of patient. I haven't seen, you know. So one case I have seen, and that case of antipyrenum of the mineral kingdom. Interesting. Now the cough operation after. It's an interesting rule. After the operation of fistula, I get coughing complaints so much. So what should be the rubric? You never find this type of rubric anywhere. It's of bulbaris vulgaris, calcarea fossa, and silica. I think I've given silica. Interesting. That's why I like Borix report really a lot. So now in febrile, palm heat. Very febrile heat in palm heat. It's a chenopodium. We also know the Aphis chenopedii. Interesting. You know, plant lice of chenopodium. Interesting. So it's of animal kingdom, insecta. You know, this type of rubric you won't find in any report. I can guarantee you that. Now, Bruce watery goats. Interesting, verruca situated on nose, finger, and eyebrow. It's for causticum. Interesting. Scrotum spots brown. I've seen this case. You know, whole scrotum has brownish spots. It's for conium. How would you get this type of symptom? Vagina coldness. There's coldness in vagina. It's a boric acid. Interesting. You won't reach there. Anyhow. Cancer in general of cecum. So cancer remedies in general of cecum. It's of, you know, it's a unique medicine. My sir has used this one time. It's of Ornithogalum umbellatum, star of vellum of the plant kingdom. Interesting. So at last I want to show reverence to all my gurus who taught me so much. You contact to me Nishant25smilebox@gmail.com and do subscribe to my channel.